Let's take a look at two examples of converting points in rectangular coordinates to polar coordinates, and this time we'll use radians. So the first step is to identify the coordinates of the given point. This point has coordinates 3, negative 3, which tells us x equals 3 and y equals negative 3. Now if we want to express this point in polar coordinates, we want to determine r and theta. And remember, there's an infinite number of ways to express a point in polar coordinates. Let's just say we want to have a positive value for r and the least positive value for theta. If r is positive, that means the terminal side of the angle would have to pass through the given point. So the terminal side of theta would have to be here. So it's often helpful to sketch a reference triangle to visualize what's happening here. So this would be our reference triangle. We would label this side of the reference triangle positive 3 and this side negative 3. Now you may recognize this reference triangle as a 45, 45, 90 right triangle, which it is, but we're going to assume we don't recognize this and go ahead and determine r and theta using the formulas. So again, if we want the least positive angle for theta, it's going to be the angle that has the initial side here and the terminal side here. And then r is going to be the length of this hypotenuse. So to determine these angles, we have these formulas that can help us. We have r squared equals x squared plus y squared, which is just the Pythagorean theorem. And then we have the equation tangent theta equals y divided by x, as long as x doesn't equal 0. So we're basically solving this problem using right triangle trigonometry. Let's start by determining the value of r. We know that r squared must be equal to x squared plus y squared. So we'll have 3 squared plus negative 3 squared. So we're going to have r squared equals 9 plus 9, that's 18. So now we can square root both sides of the equation. This is going to give us r equals, well, 18 is 9 times 2. So this will be plus or minus 3 square root 2. And since we're trying to use a positive value for r for our polar coordinates, we're going to use positive 3 square root 2 for r. Now we're left to determine theta. Now let's go ahead and determine theta. Again, we should recognize theta based upon this isosceles right triangle, but we'll assume we don't. We know that tangent theta would be equal to y divided by x. Well, y divided by x would be negative 3 divided by 3, or negative 1. So if we take the inverse tangent of both sides of the equation, theta would be equal to inverse tangent of negative 1. Let's go to the calculator and see what angle this gives us. First step is to check the mode. Let's change the mode to radians. Press enter. Go back to the home screen. Second tangent, negative 1. Now you might not recognize this, but this is actually negative pi over 4 radians. Let's go ahead and write this down and then we'll take a look at our sketch again. Now negative pi over 4 radians would be a correct angle for theta. Notice how the terminal side would pass through the given point. But if we really want to have the least positive angle for theta, that would be 315 degrees, or in radians, that would be 7 pi over 4 radians. Let's go and take a look at a second example. The given point in rectangular coordinates would be negative 4, negative 3. And again, let's go ahead and see if we can use a positive value for r, which means the terminal side of theta would have to pass through this point. So this would be our reference triangle, where we would label this leg negative 4, this leg negative 3, and this would be r. And again, we're trying to determine r and theta for this point given in rectangular coordinates. So we have r squared is equal to negative 4 squared plus negative 3 squared. So we have r squared is equal to 16 plus 9, that's 25. Well, this one comes out nice. We have r equals plus or minus 5. Again, if we want to use a positive value for r, then we're going to use positive 5. And then if we want theta to be the least positive angle, that would be this angle here. Well, let's use our trig equation tangent theta equals y divided by x and see what the calculator gives us. So y divided by x would be negative 3 divided by negative 4, or positive 3 fourths. Therefore, theta would be equal to inverse tangent of 3 fourths. Now, right away, I can tell the calculator is not going to give us the correct function value, because remember that the range of inverse tangent is from 0 to pi radians, or from 0 to negative pi over 2 radians. But it will give us the information we need to determine what theta would be. So now we'll press second tangent 3 fourths, and it's going to give us an angle in the first quadrant, which is approximately 0.64 radians. Well, 0.64 radians would have a terminal side that points in the opposite direction here, which would be okay if we change the sign of r. Remember, if r is negative, the terminal side of theta would point in the opposite direction. So if we use negative 5, 0.64 radians, this would be the same point in polar coordinates. But if we really want to use a positive value for r, this 0.64 radians would be the reference angle in the third quadrant. So our angle theta in red here would be equal to pi plus 0.64 radians. So 3.14 plus 0.64 would give us approximately 3.78 radians. Again, both of these represent the same point. One has a positive value of r, and one has a negative value for r. I hope you found this helpful.